हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग फर्स्ट टेस्ट ऑफ क्रैश प्रोग्राम. आई एम रमेश पणिकर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ KNA. वी आर मेकिंग दिस वीडियो. लुक एट क्वेश्चन नंबर 46. वी आर गिवन कैल्शियम कार्बाइड रिएक्ट्स विद वाटर टू प्रोड्यूस एसिटिलीन एंड देन एसिटिलीन इज हाइड्रोजनेटेड टू गिव इथीन. And we are given that polyethylene is getting formed. All right. Question is, how much polyethylene is prepared from 400 grams of calcium carbonate? Now, if you look at calcium carbide, the molar mass is 40 plus 24, that is equal to 64 grams. 64 gram is producing 26 grams of acetylene. This is 26 grams. All right, and this 26 gram, 26 gram is again hydrogenated to ethane. Its mass is 28. So regarding the source of hydrogen, we are not bothered because we have to calculate the amount of polyethylene from this much of calcium carbide. All right, so the question is, from 64 grams we are getting 26 grams of acetylene, or you can say 28 grams of ethane. All right, ethene, because it is first converted to acetylene and then converted to ethene. So what is the we are given 400 grams of calcium carbide, so 400 grams will produce. So this is 400 into 28 divided by 64, that is it. If you calculate, you get 175. All right, grams, second answer. And look at the second question. Equivalent mass of H2SO4 in this particular reaction. See, normally if the question is what is the equivalent mass of H2SO4, we will say it is molar mass divided by 2. All right, but in this reaction, if you concentrate the reaction, only one H positive of hydrogen is getting transferred. All right, and what is the equivalent mass of an acid? It is given by molar mass divided by replaceable. We simply say replaceable H positive. All right, so normally in H2SO4 we have two hydrogen which can be substituted, so M by 2. But if a reaction is given, we have to follow that reaction. So you have to tell how many H positive are actually substituted. So only one hydrogen, so it is M by 1. Now look at question number 48. Question number 48. All right, in question number 48 we are given a mixture of CO2 and CO. We are given a mixture of CO2 and CO. This mixture is 1 liter, and now in this mixture we are adding charcoal, and the total volume becomes 1.4 liters. All right, so the point is carbon monoxide is unaffected. It is mentioned only carbon dioxide combined with carbon to produce twice of CO. This is in solid state. Carbon is in solid state. So the point is CO2 is 1 minus x, and this value is say 2x. All right, so 1 minus x plus 2x is equal to, it says, 1.4 liter. All right, the part which is getting converted is actually x, and this is one equal to 1.4 liter. It is mentioned. All right, now 1 plus x. All right, this is equal to 1.4, or x equals 0.4. So 0.4 is how much percentage of 1? It is 40%. So 40% of CO2 and remaining is 60%, that is carbon monoxide. All right. Question number 49, N factor of oxalic acid. Oxalic acid is a dibasic acid. All right. So we are not bothered about this twice of H2O. Masses are taken into consideration, but how many replaceable H positive are there? 2. So its valence factor is 2. Now look at question number 50. In 50, we have a relation E is equal to minus 13.6 Z square upon N square. All right. Now for Li 3 positive and He single positive, the N factor, the shell number remain constant, and this 13.6 is also constant. So we can use this relation E1 upon Z1 square, that is equal to E2 upon Z2 square, or you can say E1 upon E2. E1 is value is given, it is 4.41 into 10 raised to power minus 17, all right, upon Z1 square. Z, you can say for lithium, Z is 3, 3 the square is 9. E2 we have to find out, and Z2 square for He positive, it is 2 the square equal to 4. Just calculate E2, you will get third option. Now look at question number 51. which set of quantum number represent highest amount of energy? Energy of a shell is given by N plus subshell is given by N plus L. Larger the value of N plus L, greater is the energy. So 3 plus 2, 5, 4 plus 2, 6. So third option is correct. All right. We are not bothered about magnetic quantum number and spin quantum number. Now, look at question number 52, increasing order of ionization energy. So on the basis of their position, we have boron, all right, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and left to right it should increase, and we have beryllium as well, so left to right it should increase, all right, but beryllium due to completely full configuration shows higher value than boron, and nitrogen due to P3 configuration shows higher value than oxygen. So according to which the correct answer is third. Now which is neutral oxide? That you must remember that N2O and CO, they are neutral oxides. All right. So correct answer is second option.